Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about isoenzymes. So this is a part of our unit 3. So coming to isoenzymes, in this topic we have to discuss lactate dehydrogenase. So coming to isoenzymes, isoenzymes are nothing but the multiple forms of an enzyme which differ in physical and chemical properties and catalyze the same reaction as an enzyme. Isoenzymes are produced by a single gene and sometimes result from more than one gene. Generally, isoenzymes can be separated by heat inactivation, chemical inhibition, and the third one is electrophoretic techniques. Out of these three, electrophoretic technique is widely adopted. So, how we will separate by electrophoresis means? So, electrophoresis is a technique by which we can separate by the movement of charged particles through an electrolyte when subjected to electrical field. Next, we will see the different forms of isoenzymes. The first one is CPK, which is called as threonine phosphokinase. The second one is lactate dehydrogenase, and this is the example in our syllabus which we have to give. And the third one is troponin. Fourth one is alkaline phosphatase, which is represented as ALP, Fifth one is aldolase, So what are the five types of isoenzymes means? First one is the CPK, which is called threonine phosphokinase. Second one is lactate dehydrogenase, which is represented as LDH. Third one is the troponin. Fourth one is alkaline phosphatase, which is represented as ALP, and fifth one is aldolase. Now we will see lactate dehydrogenase. So lactate dehydrogenase is an enzyme which is present in a wide variety of organisms. Coming to the classification of lactate dehydrogenase, it is given by enzyme code 1. 1 means it belongs to oxidoreductase, and the EC number for lactate dehydrogenase is 1.1.1.27. So 1.1.1.27, which indicates it belongs to oxidoreductase and it will act on CHOH group of the donor, and mainly for this enzyme NAD or NADP act as acceptor. So this is the significance of enzyme code, or what is the information we get from enzyme code 1.1.27 means it belongs to oxidoreductases and it will act or clean the CHOH group of the donor. And for this group of enzyme, NAD or NADP acts as acceptor. Coming to the features, it is having a molecular weight of 32 kilodaltons and it is a tetramer. Tetramer means it is made up of 4 polypeptide chains, and these tetramers are of 2 types, M type and K. M indicates it belongs to muscle, it is specific for muscle. H means heart. So coming to the M or muscle tetramer, it is encoded by the gene present on the chromosome 11 and it is basic in nature. Coming to the H, H indicates harm, and this tetramer is abundant in harm, and this tetramer is encoded by the gene present on the 12, and this tetramer is, or harm tetramer is acidic in nature. So coming to the lactate dehydrogenase function, what is the main function of lactate dehydrogenase means? It reversibly converts lactate to pyruvate. It converts lactate to pyruvate. And coming to the types of isoenzymes, so LDH consists of 5 isoenzymes. They are the LDH1, LDH2, LDH3, LDH4 and LDH5. And these isoenzymes are generally separated by cellulose acetate electrophoresis, FPH8.6. So the isoenzymes of lactate dehydrogenase are separated by cellulose acetate electrophoresis at pH 8.6. Coming to the normal values of lactate dehydrogenase, the serum contains 100 to 200 units per liter. The cerebrospinal fluid, CSF, It contains 730 units per liter, and Umurin contains LDH in a range of 4 to 100 units per liter. So these are the normal values of lactate dehydrogenase. So this is the equation which represents the function of lactate dehydrogenase. So lactate dehydrogenase acts on lactate and it is converted to myelin. What will happen means lactate will undergo oxidation and the hydrogen is accepted by NAD plus and NAD plus is converted to NADH. So what is the reaction means lactate is or NAD plus it converts lactate to pyridine and the pH. So this is a reversible reaction. So conversion of lactate to pyridine occurs at pH 8.2 9.8. Whereas conversion of pyridine to lactate, which is a reverse reaction, it will occur or this reaction is specific in the range of pH 7.4 to 7.8. So this is about the reaction carried by lactate dehydrogenase. Now we will see the different forms of isomers. So if we see the isoenzymes of lactate dehydrogenase, so the first column indicates the isoenzymes of lactate dehydrogenase. And coming to the existence, so what are the tissues where it is forming? And this is the subunit composition and the highest value is formed. So coming to the first one, that is LDH1. So LDH1 will contain four half subunits. So it is represented as H4, and it is mainly found in heart and kidneys. And second one is LDH2. LDH2 contains three half subunits and one muscle subunit, and it is available in red blood cells, heart, kidney, and brain. Coming to the third category, that is LDH3, which is having equal proportions of heart subunits and muscle subunits. So it is represented as H2N2, and it is mainly present abundant in brain, lung, and white blood cells. So LDH2 is more in the red blood cells, and LDH3 is more in the white blood cells. And next, coming to the fourth category, that is the LDH4. LDH4 is composed of one heart subunit and three muscle subunits, and mainly it is seen abundant in lung skeletal muscles. And the last one is LDH5, and this LDH5 is totally composed of four muscle subunits, hence it is represented as M4. And it is mainly abundantly formed in skeletal muscle and liver. So this is about the LDH composition and their existence. So this slide shows the composition and existence and in which conditions the levels are increased. So coming to LDH1, it is composed of four heart subunits, that is HHH, and it is mainly seen in RBC and myocardium. It mainly exists in myocardium and RBC, and the levels are increased during myocardial infarctions. Coming to LDH2, it is represented as H3N1. That means it is composed of three heart subunits and one muscle subunit, and it is represented as HHH, three H's and one muscle subunit. And mainly it is present in myocardium. Myocardium is nothing but the membrane surrounding the muscle, heart muscle. And next one is RBC. Coming to LDH3, it is equally composed of two subunits of heart and two subunits of muscle. Hence it is represented as H2M2, and it is composed of HHMM. And mainly it is seen in kidney and skeletal muscles. And the fourth one is LDH4. It is having one heart muscle and three muscle subunits. So it is represented as H1N3. And it is having one H3Ns. And mainly it exists in abundantly formed in kidney and skeletal muscle. And the last isoenzyme is LDH5, which is composed of four muscle subunits. So it is represented as MMMM. 4Ms. That means tetramer is totally specific for muscle. Mainly it exists in skeletal muscles and liver. And LDH5 levels are elevated during skeletal, muscle, and liver diseases. So LDH values, for example, LDH5 values are raised, see now, which indicates, our that condition indicates that the person is suffering with skeletal muscle disorders or liver diseases. In the same way, if LDH1 values are increased beyond the normal level, which indicates clearly the person is suffering with myocardial infarction, that means he is suffering with heart disease. So this is about the significance of isoenzymes. So coming to the clinical significance of LDH. So in normal serum, that means in a healthy person, LDH2 predominant isoenzyme and LDH5 is releasing. That means in a healthy person, LDH2 will be in elevated levels. But in case of myocardial infarction, LDH1 levels will be increased. Generally, LDH2 levels should be in significant amounts, but in myocardial infarction conditions, LDH1 levels will indicate. So, an increase in LDH1 levels indicates myocardial infarction. The person is suffering with myocardial infarction. Now, we will see the second condition, megaloblastic anemia. So, generally in a healthy person, LDH2 levels will be in a higher values. But in megaloblastic anemia conditions, 50 times upper limit of LDH1 and LDH2. So, that means LDH1 values will be increased 50 times. And in case of muscular dystrophy, LDH5 values will be increased. That means LDH5 values will be more than LDH2 values. And so by these values, we can say the person with which type of disease the person is suffering. So lactate dehydrogenase enzyme is said to be a serum marker enzyme. Serum marker enzyme. Coming to the renal diseases. During renal diseases, LDH3 values will be elevated to a great extent. That means in normal person, LDH2 levels will be elevated, but in case of renal diseases like tubular necrosis, pyelonephritis, pulmonary embolism, LDH3 levels will be increased to a great extent. That, and total LDH values will be increased in neoplastic diseases. Okay, now next coming to LDH5. The LDH5 is increased to a great extent in breast cancer, malignancies of central nervous system, and in prostatic carcinomas. That means today, prostatic carcinomas, the LDH5 value will be elevated. So, by seeing the elevated levels of LDH5, we can say the person is suffering with carcinoma. Next one, in leukemias. That means in WBC cancers, LDH2 and LDH3 levels are increased to a great extent. And next one, in malignant tumors of testes and ovaries, LDH2, LDH3 and LDH5 levels are increased to a great extent. So by this we can say that LDH, lactate dehydrogenase enzyme, can be termed as serum marker enzymes. So this is about isoenzyme lactate dehydrogenase. Thank you all.